we present SplineCam, a framework for exact visualization and characterization of deep neural network geometry and decision boundary. Deep neural networks with piecewise linear activations like leaky ReLU or sawtooth are affine spline operators, which means a DNN partitions its input space into linear regions and affinely maps input vectors from any given region to the output. A lot like origami, deep neural networks fold, bend, and stretch the input space to fit any given function. SplineCam is the first method to exactly compute these folds or partitions formed by a neural network on arbitrary 2D subspaces of the input space. We provide SplineCam as a PyTorch toolbox that can be used to visualize and study implicit neural representations, locally characterize deep neural networks based on partition statistics, as well as monitor and compare characteristics during training. Suppose we have our ReLU activated DNN, F theta, with a three-dimensional input space and a two-dimensional output space. F theta has been pre-trained to take as input 3D coordinates X and classify whether the coordinate is inside or outside the sphere. Suppose we are also given a two-polytope Z as a region of interest, and we wish to compute the partition induced by the neural network on Z. Each neuron from any given layer of the Z network divides the input space into positive and negative half spaces. Therefore, any ReLU activated neuron can be represented as a hyperplane as its zero level set. Since all the hyperplanes of the first layer are in R3, we project the hyperplanes on the region of interest Z. Following that, we compute the graph G formed by the intersection of these hyperplanes with Z. Next, we use a novel graph search algorithm to find the faces or cycles of the computed graph. Each of these cycles are the linear regions of the partition formed by the first layer of our network. After obtaining the first layer partition on Z, we analytically compute the per-region affine parameters for each of these regions. In this way, we end up with a piecewise affine operation that maps inputs from Z to the input of the second layer of the network. Since the operations are per-region affine, we can now back-project the layer 2 hyperplanes onto Z, which are denoted here in red. By this way, we can compute the hyperplane projections and affine parameters in a layer-wise fashion, and analytically compute the partition induced by the neural network on a region of interest Z. To obtain the decision boundary, considering two softmax output neurons, we can use the same method to analytically find the set of points in the input space that makes both outputs equal. SplineCam is fast and scalable. Except for the graph search algorithm, every operation in SplineCam is vectorized and implemented for GPU using PyTorch. We can benchmark the speed of SplineCam by running it on a single ReLU layer, and we present the plots to the right. We sweep the width of the network of a layer on the x-axis, which we denote by n, and we change the input space dimensionality between each plotted line. We see that for a layer with width 1000 and dimensionality 8002, SplineCam needs around 134 seconds to find 132,000 regions. SplineCam also works for a very large class of architectures, for example, with convolutions, skip connections, pooling, batch normalizations, and a lot more. For large deep networks like VGG16, SplineCam approximately needs 7 minutes to find 1,000 regions. SplineCam is fast, scalable, and exact, up to machine precision. Being exact can be especially important when the partition has very small regions, since sampling with approximations in such settings can be quite erroneous. Since regions become smaller as the size of the network grows, SplineCam can be very important in studying state-of-the-art networks with provable visualizations and provable empirical observations. SplineCam can be used to visualize decision boundaries and sample infinitely many points that are provably on the boundary. Looking at these samples can also provide us insights on the bias of the network. For example, here we present partition visualizations and samples from the decision boundary of an MLP trained on fashion MNIST in the top row and a CNN trained on MNIST in the bottom row. We see that while the samples from the fashion MNIST decision boundary look quite ambiguous, Some of the MNIST boundary samples look like the digit 3. This can be an indication of bias in the network or bias in the decision boundary in the locality. Using SplineCam, we can also compute the margin for different training samples as well as adversarial examples. In the plot to our right, we show an adversarial example generated via projected gradient descent, as well as two training samples. SplineCam can be used to study the effect of positional encoding or periodic activations in implicit neural representations, or INRs. To study periodic encodings, we train a 2D INR with clipped sawtooth position encoding as a piecewise linear approximation for sinusoid. In the top row of this figure, we present visualizations of neurons from each layer individually projected to the input space. Each neuron is assigned a unique color, while only one neuron from each layer is highlighted in red. The top row shows neurons for a network that was trained with position encoding, whereas the bottom row presents for a network trained without. We see that with position encoding, ReLU neurons, especially from the shallower layers, are repeated periodically in the input space because position encoding wraps up the input space. This makes neurons share more weight across non-contiguous parts of the input space, which can possibly be attributed to better convergence. We can also monitor the training dynamics of DNNs via SplineCam. For example, here we are training an MLP on MNIST and visualizing the partition on a 2D ROI that intersects three training points from the MNIST training set. Each region is color-coded by the norm of the slope parameter for that region. Within the first couple iterations, the network learns a coarse decision boundary that is slowly fine-tuned as training progresses. The function learned in this region is also very flat initially, but as training progresses, we see both the function exhibiting changes in the per-region slope, as well as the decision boundary getting more curved. SplineCam can also be used to quantify partition statistics and compare between deep networks, as well as training decisions. Here we present partition statistics computed on randomly oriented 2D slices centered on 90 different test samples from TinyImageNet. In these plots, we compare between a VGG11 in the top row and a VGG16 in the bottom row, trained with and without data augmentation. We see that data augmentation significantly increases the partition density around test points for the shallower VGG11 network, but the difference is not as pronounced for the deeper VGG16 network. Such partition statistics can be interesting and very useful to characterize deep neural networks or study their local complexity or generalizability that has been previously reported in literature. We'll be presenting SplineCam at CVPR this year. Please consider visiting us during our poster session to brainstorm new ideas. Thank you for watching.